Rembrandt Hermanszoon van Rijn was a Dutch painter, craftsman, and etcher. He experienced an extremely successful art career before his economic downfall in the 1650s. While he died in poverty and had outlived both his son and wife, his body of work is still celebrated internationally owing to his extraordinary artistic prowess. The world-renowned artist is best known for his exceptional skills at depicting human moods, emotions, and figures with near-accurate precision, and his understanding of the role of light and shade that he translated through his paintings. His artworks mainly included biblical, historical scenes and an abundance of portraits as well as self-portraits. Rembrandt set out to begin his apprenticeship as a painter at the young age of 14 in his hometown Leiden in the Netherlands, eventually moving to Amsterdam in 1624 to master his skills as a painter. Unlike most painters his age, Rembrandt did not travel abroad or visit Italy to further his art exposure. Instead, he relied on local teachers like Leiden-based painter Jacob van Swanenburg, historical pieces painter Peter Lastman, and self-taught skills. While his initial work sees a number of sketches, he developed his own style of painting in the 1630s that focused greatly on lighting and shadow, fine brushwork, and portraying texture to achieve realism through his artworks. In his paintings like Peter and Paul Disputing, Christ in the Storm on the Sea of Galilee, and Night Watch, his experimentation with light and the spotlight effect can be seen clearly. In The Night Watch, painted in 1642, which is one of the first group portraits in action from that time, Rembrandt shows civic guardsmen taking up their positions in order to march out. In the painting, Captain Franz Bannockburn, one of the main characters of the visual narrative, is painted in light. His hand, which gestures the soldiers to come out to march, casts a shadow on Lieutenant Willem van Rutenberg, standing next to him, indicating accurately the direction from which the light in the painting falls. Rembrandt draws a sharp contrast of light and dark in the painting by drawing the most important characters in light and the rest in shadow. It is also believed that the figure in the center of the painting, with just one part of his face visible, may be the painter himself, owing to the resemblance to his self-portraits. Another painting where Rembrandt is rumored to have painted himself in a group portrait is in The Christ in the Storm on the Sea of Galilee from 1633. Again, an unprecedented example of his use of light and shade to highlight the churning of the sea and the chaos, the painting is his only known seascape and one of the artworks that was stolen in the infamous art robbery in 1990 at the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum. Other stolen Rembrandt artworks from the museum are A Lady and Gentleman in Black and the etching portrait of the artist as a young man, both from 1633. The paintings still remain missing to this day. With time, Rembrandt's work became more expressive. He translated details like ornaments and exotic fabrics with great precision using not just the brush and glowing paint, but also palette knives and often the back of his brush. This created a textured effect on his paintings, making his artworks more lifelike. Rembrandt's expertise in three-dimensional and illusionist art can be noticed in his only still life painting, Still Life with Peacocks from 1639. The depiction of faces and expressions in his portraits won him many private commissions for portraits during the span of his career. One such commissioned painting was The Syndics from 1662, where he painted the syndics of the Drapers Guild in a group portrait. X-rays of the paintings show how Rembrandt made many changes while working on it in order to get it right. The fact that the painting was to be hung high on a wall was accounted for with the position of the table and the syndics showing to be looking down at the viewer. His self-portraits perhaps are the earliest examples of the millennial selfie, also known then as contrefacet. The term can also be seen under his signature in his self-portrait at the age of 34, housed at the National Gallery in London. The painting shows him leaning over what seems like a windowsill. The painter has used the limited palette of earthy tones and has painted the background to manipulate the viewer's interest by making it dark in some places and brighter in others. On looking closely, the texture of fur and other fabric details on his shirt come through. Painting with accurate detailing on texture was one of Rembrandt's painting styles, and while he only used the wrong side of the paintbrush for the texture on this painting, the details are almost lifelike. He also used his unique style to create a puffed-up illusion on the sleeve of his outfit. Rembrandt's international fame and success continued well into the 1640s, leading him to become a compulsive art collector and collector of various antiquities as well as weapons. By the time of his death, it is said that two rooms of his house had been filled with his collection. After facing a monetary crisis in the 1650s and filing for bankruptcy, the artist ended up selling his art collectibles and house where he lived and worked for 20 years. The house was then turned into Rembrandt House Museum, a museum dedicated to the work and life of the world's greatest artists.